That's when you learn about people, you learn to ask questions a certain way, and whether the answer is truthful or not.
Special Agent Jerry Jones chooses a suspect and begins the interrogation. Like most agents, he starts by interviewing the suspect about matters that do not pertain to the case at hand. This helps him to choose an appropriate interrogation strategy.
It just becomes instinct. While talking to these people, you are able to develop a concept of what their greatest fear is, some weakness they may have in their past or their family or something of that sort. And in this particular case, it was fear of the death penalty.
Knowing that the suspect is unaware that the teller Amy Shaw is now safe, Agent Jones sees his opportunity and decides to exploit it.
And what I told him was that my main concern was the safety and well-being of the victim teller.
I want her back alive. If your friend kills her...
Had the third robber killed her...
You're going to let go of that.
They would both have faced the death penalty.
Jones knows that his choice to use this common technique must be measured. It could backfire. It may strengthen the suspect's resolve not to speak at all.
I like to tell me the truth.
But the agent's plan works. Faced with the prospect of his worst fear coming true, the suspect admits his involvement in the crime and names the lead gunman, Christopher Jaberk. Police quickly arrest Jaberk at his mother's house just over the state line in Georgia. He's convicted on all charges. But Jaberk's crime spree has just begun. Before he can be sentenced, he escapes from jail with a bank robber named Jerome Frierson Bay. Authorities immediately lock down the area. Despite a massive manhunt, they...